So now we have next topic called Git branching. Now, what is Git branching? Let's suppose, and Git branching is very important. And just for a quick revision, what we did yesterday, we talked about what is version controlling system, how many types of version controlling system we have. And then we talked about Git. In Git, we know how we can start version controlling, how we can create tags. And then in end, we did push to our github.com, right? So then our team members can collaborate easily. They can download whenever they want to. The benefit of Git is this is DVCS, right? A distributed version controlling system. So we don't need to depend on anyone, right? Like if I have 10 developers, so code will be available on all the 10 machines as well as on central server. This is the power of Git, right? And that's why Git is very famous. And yesterday, you have also seen Git is not very difficult, right? Commands were very, very, very simple. Only one time practice is required, and then you will be able to follow easily, right? So now we have next topic called Git branch. Now, what is Git branch? Let's suppose, guys, we have our production server, okay? I'm supposing this is my production server. I'm writing here, okay? This is my production server. Now, on this production server, we have some developer, and this developer is working on some code, right? Now, when this developer is working in some code, so I'm supposing we have code stored on github.com, right? Now, once code is stored on github.com, so we have all the code available, right? Now, the same code, I'm supposing whatever code I have, I gave path in my production server. This is my production server, right? Now, what will happen? Code created by developer is now available on production server. So whenever our customer, actually this can't be mirrored. So let's suppose this customer, when he is accessing our application, so he will see page, right? So our customer is happy. Now, guys, let's suppose this developer created some code and all working fine. But do you think this is one time? No. Why? Because of when we launch any product in a world, so maybe we will continuously upgrade our product, right? In order to enhance experience of customer, in order to enhance security of our product. So we will not be static, right? So what we need is we want our developer to continuously work on our code. Well, if our developer will work on directly code and will push to github.com and the code will be in production server. So we don't know the code developer. Let's suppose this developer created some code, right? And then code is sent to this our github.com. And then as we have given path of in production server, so the same code will our user will see. But maybe the code which is created by developer is not completely ready, right? Maybe there was some issue. So this is not a recommended way to directly do changes on GitHub, or I will say directly do changes on our main code, because of it can interrupt our production server. Second part is, let's suppose we have our customer, right? This customer is happy right now. Maybe because of some bugs, now customer is not happy. Customer is saying that, hey team, something needs to be improved. Customer gave one feedback. Let's suppose customer saying that payment portal is not working fine. Okay, or maybe something is not working fine. Well, we are, let's suppose, operation manager, developer manager, right? We all are here. So guys, will you directly do modification on main code? Never, right? Because of we may have thousands of customer, right? We may have millions of customer. So because of one customer, we will not interrupt our code, right? But we also know that we need to work on the feedback, right? So now question is, how we will work on feedback of customer, right? And because of one feedback, I don't want to interrupt other customer. So now we know two issue. Our main code we cannot change. Second, if customer is saying any feedback, So how we will work on that feedback, right? Without interrupting our production server. So we have a concept called git branching. Now guys, if you remember when yesterday we were pushing code, so that time we were using git push c dot master, right? Now what is master? When you do commit for the first time, so it automatically create a branch for you. So I'm repeating just last few part. Like what I said, if our developer wants to continuously work on our code, so we will not change in our main code. Because if our main code is working in production server, right? And if we will do any modification in our main code, then maybe our all the customers will face issue, right? This is about one issue. Second issue I said, let's suppose if we have many customer, right? And if any customer will give feedback in terms of fixing some issue, fixing some bugs. So in that case, so thus you may need to check something then from your end. So this, if any customer is giving any issue, so we need to fix it, but we also don't want to interrupt our production server, right? So in that case, what we can do, we have concept called git branch. Now, if you remember guys, yesterday we were doing git commit, right? And when we do git commit, so it automatically create a branch for you called master. So now what is master? Master is your main branch where by default all the code is stored, okay? Now, best practices, do not work on master branch, work on some different branch. But by default, when you do commit, so it automatically create a master branch for you. So what you can do, you can give master branch code to production server, right? So you can, instead of giving GitHub URL, you can give master URL in production server. And let's suppose if developer wants to work on code, right? So what we can do, we can create a separate branch. Let's suppose this is my branch, and branch, I'm saying developer. I can give any name. Now, when I will say dev branch, so this is copy of same code, okay? Copy of same master branch. But the benefit is, if we will do anything in dev branch, it will not affect our master branch. So it is like both are different room. One branch changes will not affect other branch changes, right? So instead of making changes now in direct master branch, we can do changes in dev branch. Now you will say, Gaurav, you are saying a dev branch is a different branch and master is different, right? So what we can do? And what we can do in the sense, like let's suppose my developer work is done, right? And now I want to give this code in this master branch. So question is how we can give. So guys, we have concept of merge, M-E-R-G-E. So once your work is done, then you can simply do merge. So with merge, what will happen? All the code which you have in dev will be merged with your master branch. And this way, you're not affecting master branch. You can test your dev branch. And once everything is done, then you can merge your code, else not, right? And here we can have manager between and manager on master branch. So if anyone wants to merge their code, they will first need to take approval from manager. I will show you from where you can define. And then we will merge. Same way, let's suppose if our customer said any issue. So what we can do, we can create a new branch, right? Let's suppose hash a bug one. Maybe you have seen this in your company before, hash bug one. This is just a name, okay? You can give any name. So bug one. Now, what your developer can do, developer can check what is the issue, and as per our customer feedback, our developers can fix the code, and once code is fixed, then we can merge our code. So the benefit is we are not affecting our master branch directly, right? We are working on different branch, and you know one branch will not affect other branch, right? So now I will show you practically. If anyone have any question, please ask. So now question is how we can work with our branching concept, right? So I'm going, guys, this is very important, right? And well, everything is very important. Every day I always say, because of actually everything is important. So let me now go in the machine. So this is our developer machine. I'm logged in github.com. Now what I'm doing, I'm creating my new project, right? It can be any project. So yesterday I created my project and my project too, right? So what I'm doing now, I'm saying mkdir, today I may will ask some questions from you. So mkdir, my project three. So now I'm going in my project three, sorry, cd my project three, I am in, and here, let's create a file. So I'm creating a file, maybe vim, right? And we can say anything. Maybe let's say I'm saying, hello, let me create a index.html page. Okay, you will see in a better way. So vim index.html, I can give any name, enter. Let's type here h1, and I can say anything. I'm saying we are learning git branching and we are in master branch. Okay, you can type anything, whatever you want to. H1, save and quit. So we are learning git branching, we are in master branch. So now my question from you, as this is a new folder, so what commands needs to be followed in order to save this file in Git? I'm not talking about push, I'm talking about in local. How? Git init,
git add. Git init, git add, git to, git commit.
Very good. So git commit, hyphen a, hyphen m. Let's suppose I'm my project. Anything, or let's say index.html file added. Okay. So now we can see we have index.html, right? And I'm also showing you again content, cat index.html, right? And now guys, if I will show you in which branch I am, so can you see? It is showing you master branch. As I said, so Ben, when you do commit for the first time, so it automatically create a master branch for you. Now you will say, Gaurav, how we can create our branch? This is pre-created, right? Please see everything. I will go very slow here, right? This is actually very amazing. When I learned for the first time, I was in love with, and today also I'm in love with Git. This is very amazing. See now. So I'm creating a branch. So if you want to create a branch, we can say Git branch, and we can give what name you want to create. So let's suppose I'm saying dev. Okay, enter. Created. It's very simple. If you want to check now, so you can see now we have master branch and we have dev branch, right? Now you will say, Gaurav, okay, one thing before I move. When I did git branch dev, so what happened in backend, it actually created a copy from master branch to dev branch. Everything is in same folder, right? Now, if I want to go to dev branch, here we can simply say git checkout, and where you want to go in dev branch, and we are in. Now, if I will type git branch, can I say star is coming in dev, right? It means now we are in dev branch. Now what I'm doing, we have file, right? Like I'm saying vim, I'm going in my index.html, right? Let's add a line, okay? Maybe I'm saying h2, we can add any line, right? And we are saying we're learning git branch, right? This is automation training, okay? Anything, and then close. This is just a content. It's up to you, whatever you want to type. Save and quit. Enter. Done. Now, because of we are in dev branch, guys, every room, when I say room, room means different branches, right? So every room is independent. So whatever we are doing in dev, it is not affecting master branch, right? So I'm showing you cat index.html. We have two lines now, right? And as I mentioned, it is not affecting different branch, right? And this is independent. And as this is independent, we can also create a new file if you want to. Let's suppose I'm creating a file vim index2.html. Okay, we can create anything. And where I'm doing everything, I'm in the branch. And again, I'm saying here h1, and I'm saying created by var, and close. Save and quit. Now, because of this is git, right? We need to use git init, sorry, git not init, git add, git commit. If you will type status, it will show you that, hey, you have untracked file index2.html. You have file index2.html, which is modified on branch dev, right? So let's say here, git add dot, git commit, hyphen a, hyphen m. And I'm saying, we can say anything. Let's say I'm saying, dev changes, okay? It's up to you. Now, if I will check get a status, so it is saying all good on branch dev, right? Now, I'm showing you something. Cart index.html, right? So cart index.html, we can see two lines. And I'm doing git checkout master. Now I'm in master branch, right? And again, I'm showing you index.html. Can you see? I have only one line, right? Again, if I will do git checkout dev, I'm taking index.html. We have two files. We have two files as well as two lines, right? And how it will work in real time. So you will give master branch code, right? In master branch URL, when you will configure, even I will show you in Jenkins, there we have option to choose branch. So what I'm doing just for a demo, what is the folder name? This is folder, right? Copy. You don't need to follow. This is just for information. I'm searching here index.html. Your file couldn't be accessed. /root/myproject3. Can anyone tell me why this error is coming? We have our file, right? But I'm not allowed to access. Any reason?
SC Linux may be lagging.
No.
That Apache server is up?
See, we don't require Apache access, right? We are directly accessing file.
Okay.
We are logged in with the student, right? It means this Google Chrome is open with the student, right? And the files which we have created with which user? Root user, right? I'm doing one thing. Never do this, right? This is not recommended. Ever. Just want to show you. Can you see? We are learning. I gave permissions, full permission. We will never do. Now, why we are seeing two lines? So we are seeing we are learning git branching, right? And we are in master branch. We can ignore this line. This is automation training, right? Because we have two lines. Now, I'm going to git checkout, and I'm saying dev, right? Sorry, not dev, master, enter. Git checkout master, where we are. Git status, where we are right now, branch. We are in dev. Okay, let's do modification maybe because of permission we gave. So git add. If you are confused whenever in git, always do git status and you will see answer. Git add dot git commit hyphen a hyphen m. Let's say I'm saying as anything, then close, right? You can see it is file permission was changed, right? Mode change. Okay. So now if I will check, you can say index.html, we are learning git branching, we are in master branch. This is automation training, right? Now I want to go to which branch? Master. So git checkout master, right? Now we are in master, same file, but we have only one line, right? And if I will move to now, let's say if here also it is saying to do anything, no. So now git checkout dev, okay, amazing. So in real time, what you will do, you will give URL of master, right? And your developer will continuously work on dev branch, like the one I showed demo here. Okay, sorry everyone, I think there was some issue. So I'm repeating again, our developers are now not changing directly master branch, we are changing dev branch. And that's how we can work. Any question here, anyone?
That means, checking to master branch will not be allowed by developer.
See, right now, everything is allowed, right? But mm-hmm. It's up to you now, Vishik. You will give permission to user for only dev branch, not master.
Okay. So first time when I'm creating the repository, master and dev, I'll create the replica. And later on, any external user, only dev, I'll allow the permission, and master, I'll not allow. I'll not allow even to check out also, right. Sir, or push or pull also. Okay, thank you.
See, pull they can do, work they can do, right? But what you can do is, Abhishek, the best practice is you can set permission on merge code. Okay. Like you can set whenever anyone will do merge code from dev to master, then permission is required. Without manager approval, it will not be allowed.
Okay. Got it. Thank you.
This concept is called, Abhishek, you can read and everyone can read, a pull request. Okay. pull request. Read about it maybe today after training, and then you will be able to know how we can increase security for master branch. Okay, so then whenever any developer will try to do changes in master, it means merge from dev or any branch to master, it will not be allowed. Request will go to manager. Like let's suppose here we are supposing Abhishek, and if Abhishek will click OK, then only code will be merged, otherwise not. So this way we will not interrupt our production server. So here we have
to. When we do a merge, then it will show the changes also. What kind of patch file is generated?
Yes. When you will do merge, it will show what happened in backend.
Sir, will you show how to have different URL for different branches?
No. I have not showed you. But see, when we will give URL in production server, so there we will do git checkout master. So how to give URL, that I will show you in Jenkins, when we will start Jenkins.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So here we have question from Vijay. So basically, after rigorous testing of the test branch successfully, dev in our case will deploy master branch to the live server. You're right, Vijay. So we will give master branch code to production server operation team, right? We will not give dev code, and we will say to our developer that if you want to do any changes, do changes in dev branch. If any bug will come, so guys, recommended practices, I will also recommend you to follow. Like we have bug, right? If any customer will give any issue, so create like bug 1, bug 2, bug 3, bug 4, bug 5, right? So this way you will have record how many times you have fixed your bug, right? And we will have branches. And once your work is done, you can merge your code to the master. I will show you how to merge. Okay, Vijay. Any other question, anyone, please ask.
So you told, okay, that we can create, okay, different branches for different bugs. So basically, finally, we want to make a release. Okay, we may pick multiple bugs together, okay, in a release. No, so we do a multi-branch merge together, or it has to be done one by one.
No. What I said, Stephen, every time issue will come, create a new branch. Okay, git branch. And let's suppose bug 1. Do the fix, whatever issue is here. And once your issue is fixed, then you can merge your code with master. In the end, master is running one code. So we will not do multi branch merging. This is only one branch merging at one time. Okay.